Welcome to this session. I'm Magnus Blomqvist. I'm a Developer Relations Manager at NVIDIA. In this session, I will show you how you can develop a highly efficient AI-based video analytics application and how it can look like when integrating this application with Milestone VMS. Video analytics solutions based on AI are deployed across a wide range of industries to increase operational efficiency and safety. Some examples are monitoring of traffic to detect various traffic violations, or for a retailer to understand more how he can optimize his shop layout by analyzing the pattern how customers have done their shopping. It is also used on construction sites and on factory floors to assist in workplace safety by detecting if employees are wearing the necessary protection, such as hard hats, protective vests, or gloves, or if they are close to dangerous machines or vehicles. Other industrial use cases are automatic optical inspection, using cameras deployed at the production line to do quality inspections, such as quality of welding points, if the correct assembly of components have been done, etc. Intelligent video analytics can also be used in healthcare to assist the personnel by detecting if a patient has fallen, if he left the bed, or if he has stayed in the same position in the bed for too long time. Some large infrastructure sites such as bridges, grid lines, and wind turbines are difficult to inspect. So instead, drones are used to detect and assess damages such as rust, tears, cracks, etc. Videos on AI and deep learning are more resilient and robust to changing conditions such as wind, rain, snow than other solutions and generate less false alarms. But these algorithms come at a cost in terms of complexity and the compute power needed. This creates challenges on how to optimize the training to make it as efficient as possible. The solution also needs to be optimized in regards to inference, in order to provide high throughput and cost-effective solutions capable of maximizing the number of video streams that can be processed. Finally, the number of devices can range in the hundreds or even thousands, and this needs to be efficiently managed. Issues, we built the Metropolis platform. It allows developers to develop, deploy, manage, and bring solutions quickly to the market for a broad set of vertical markets. Whether you're an integrator, a consultancy, or a developer, this platform is a complete toolbox to meet your needs for IVA applications. Starting from the bottom, the computing platform, the hardware consists of NVIDIA's Jetson family of system on modules for embedded devices and our discrete GPUs for server or cloud deployments. On top of that, we have the development tools and SDKs for video analytics. TensorRT allows you to optimize your model. The Triton inference server allows you to use your native models as efficiently as possible. The video codec SDKs allows you to offload the CPU and do efficient decoding and encoding on the GPU instead. In today's presentation, we will focus on the solutions on the top, which are our optimized pre-trained models, the Transfer Learning Toolkit to optimize your training, and the Deepstream SDK, which allows you to implement a highly efficient imaging pipeline. This Learning Toolkit and Deepstream are used in an end-to-end workflow. Transfer Learning Toolkit supports the training phase and allows the developer to optimize the solution using our pre-trained models. Creating and training deep neural networks involves a collection of large amounts of data, preparing this data set, and perform optimization to ensure that these models are highly accurate. Transfer Learning Toolkit can dramatically simplify this process and reduce the engineering effort needed. The optimized model can then be exported and used with the Deepstream SDK, which allows the developers to optimize the video processing during inference to increase the stream density and also deploy this solution at the scale. Jump directly to the conclusion of this session. This is a real-world example from one of our partners that illustrates the benefit of using this end-to-end workflow. The partner developed an intelligent video analytics application for a traffic monitoring use case. Using Transfer Learning Toolkit reduced the size of the required dataset quite substantially. This reduced the time for training as they needed 9 times less iteration to achieve the same accuracy. Fewer images to label also reduced the cost as they used an external company for this. Using Transfer Learning Toolkit with Deepstream also provided a much higher video throughput, and they increased the number of video streams by a factor 4 on the target hardware used. Many installations are deploying a video management system such as Milestone's XProtect. In those instances, the video analytics applications needs to be integrated with the VMS system to retrieve the video streams, process them, and return the analyzed video streams with metadata to the VMS system. This integration requires a development effort by the video analytics developer. We will show how this integration can be simplified by looking at some of Milestone's new solutions in VPS. These solutions are in pre-production, but illustrates how the whole flow can look like end-to-end and is a good starting point for developers to evaluate. This is the same slide before, but with more detail. It shows how the video streams flow and how they connect from the VMS system to the video analytics application. The cameras are configured from the VMS system. The video feed from the cameras are then directed to the Deepstream pipeline, which is integrated to the VMS using plugins developed by Milestone. We will explain a little bit more later what these plugins are. The resulting analytics is then returned to the VMS system. We will show how this can be developed. We will start with how to develop a neural network model using Transfer Learning Toolkit, and then how to implement the video analytics applications with Deepstream SDK. Before going to Learning Toolkit, let's first recall what Transfer Learning is. With Transfer Learning, you start off with an already trained model from, for example, a model zoo and retrain it with your own data. Training deep neural networks can be a major task, and the most important component of training a model is the data. Collecting and annotating datasets can be a painstaking and manual process involving hundreds or even thousands of man hours. The pre-trained model has already been trained on a large dataset, so much less data is needed to retrain it with your own data. This results in less data to be labeled and trained, which we saw before, and this results in shorter time for training and lower cost. Transfer Learning Toolkit allows you to reduce the time-consuming process of creating and optimizing models from scratch, or by using unoptimized open source models, and focus on your solution instead. Transfer Learning Toolkit is using a simple command line interface of 6 or 7 commands, and is supported on Linux using discrete GPUs for training. The developer downloads a pre-trained model from NVIDIA GPU cloud and can add their own dataset. The developer can also customize this model with new classes and scene adaptations. Flow of Transfer Learning Toolkit. An optimized and pre-trained model is first downloaded from NVIDIA GPU cloud. This requires no previous knowledge of the pre-trained model's layers or architecture. Transfer Learning Toolkit provides an offline augmentation tool which can dramatically increase the size of the dataset, which is very beneficial when collecting and labeling data is expensive or in sometimes not even possible. The tool supports various spatial augmentations such as rotation, resizing, flipping, etc., and also color space augmentations such as hue rotation, brightness offset, and contrast shift. The dataset then needs to be converted to Kitty format using the TLT data converter. The workflow then starts by training the model on the own dataset. The results of the training is evaluated, and if it's acceptable, the next step is to prune the model. If the performance is not good enough, you need to review the dataset again. Pruning is a way of optimizing the model, and we will talk a bit more about that in a minute. However, pruning the model means that it loses accuracy, so it needs to be trained again. The retrained model will then again be evaluated, and if the performance is acceptable, the model can then be exported in a format suitable to be used in Deepstream. There are retrained models that users can start with. We start looking into the meta-architecture vision models. NVIDIA provides optimized pre-trained models for image classification, object detection using common object detectors such as faster RCNN, YOLO, SSD, RetinaNet, etc., as well as instance segmentation. A broad range of backbones such as ResNet, MobileNet, DarkNet, etc. are supported. The pre-trained weights for this model are only a starting point to build more complex models from. These pre-trained weights are trained on open image dataset, and they provide a much better starting point for training versus starting from scratch or starting from random weights, as we discussed before. We also have built production quality models. These are highly accurate models that are trained on millions of objects for specific tasks, such as detecting people, detecting type and make of vehicles, face detection using IR images, etc. These models can be used to build highly accurate apps for people counting, parking management, toll booth, etc. Or into pruning. Model pruning is an important technique where model size is reduced by pruning off connections. It is popular in decision trees where certain connections are removed by traversing the graphs and figuring out what can be discarded. Pruning can reduce a number of parameters by an order of magnitude, leading to a model that runs many times faster. NVIDIA uses proprietary technology to remove unnecessary neuron connections, reducing the memory needed to store parameters by 25% or more. This example uses a very simple model to illustrate the point. The red node contributes very little to the end result and can be removed with limited impact on accuracy, but with a much simplified model. This translates in reduction of memory size as illustrated in the figure to the right, using a more realistic model. This model was reduced by more than 6 times in size. Pruned models also run faster, and in this example achieved 2 times the higher throughput compared to the unpruned model. But also, as mentioned before, after pruning a model, it needs to be retrained to recover any loss of accuracy. The benefit toolkit is quantization-aware training. Typically, AI models, when represented in lower precision, make them more compute efficient. So int 8 precision AI models are significantly faster than running inference in floating point. But quantizing FP32 or FP16 weights to int 8 after training can reduce model accuracy due to quantization errors. With a quantization-aware training feature of Transfer Learning Toolkit, quantization of weights in the training step helps produce comparable accuracy as FP16 or FP32 models compared to if quantization is performed post-training. With quantization-aware training in Transfer Learning Toolkit, developers can achieve up to twice the inference speedup while maintaining comparable accuracy to FP16. We will now continue to show how to implement the imaging pipeline using the Deepstream SDK. This shows the outline of a typical video analytics application that transforms raw pixels from the camera sensors into insights that can be acted upon. The application first captures streaming data as input from the camera sensor, which is sent over RTSP over an IP network. The video stream is then decoded from H.264 or H.265. The next step is pre-processing, such as scaling, cropping, or dewarping, to prepare it for the AI analytics. The result of the inference is then sent by a message broker as metadata to a server or cloud for further processing, analytics, and visualization. The Deepstream SDK covers all the activities shown here as part of the edge. Applications developed with the Deepstream SDK have been used in many of the applications I started the presentation with, such as traffic monitoring in a smart city, health and safety monitoring in hospitals, self-checkout and analytics in retail, detecting component defects at a manufacturing facility, etc., etc. Deepstream is a streaming analytic toolkit to build AI-powered applications. It is based on the GStreamer open source multimedia framework, and it supports application development in C, C++, as well as in Python. Deepstream can be deployed on a wide range of devices, ranging from an embedded edge device running on the Jetson platform, or it can be deployed on a larger edge server or in a data center using a discrete GPU such as a Tesla T4. The Deepstream applications can be deployed in containers, and applications can be orchestrated on the edge using Kubernetes. The core SDK consists of several optimized hardware accelerator plugins, which we will cover in a minute. One of the key capabilities of Deepstream is secure bidirectional communication between edge and cloud, and Deepstream also ships with several out-of-the-box security protocols. And to make it easier to get started, Deepstream ships with several reference applications in both Python and in C, C++. Now let's look at the underlying components of Deepstream. The primary building block is a plugin. It's based on the GStreamer framework and creates both a simple-to-understand interface as well as a very powerful capability. By enabling multi-threaded, parallel, heterogeneous processing, the plugin will provide the most optimized performance. By performing all the compute-heavy operations in a dedicated accelerator, Deepstream can achieve highest performance for video analytics tasks. Deepstream plugins also abstracts away lower-level libraries, making it easy for developers to build video analytic pipelines without having to learn all the individual libraries. Deepstream also achieves highly efficient memory management with zero memory copy between the plugins. This is a typical video analytics application, starting from input video to outputting insights, all the individual blocks of various plugins that are used. At the bottom are the different hardware engines that are utilized throughout the application to make sure that the processing is done as efficient as possible, using the most optimized hardware accelerator for the task. This is plugins that you can use with the Deepstream SDK. NVIDIA provides 15 hardware accelerated plugins. Some examples of the NVIDIA plugins that you can use are a plugin for video and image decode and encode. Another one is the inference plugin that uses TensorRT, NVIDIA's inference accelerator, and for object detection, image classification, and segmentation. We also provide a plugin that includes various object trackers. We have another plugin with the capability to send messages to the cloud using various protocols. Milestone has developed two plugins that can be used to connect XProtect with Deepstream. The first one removes XProtect headers from the video frames so that they can be understood by the NVIDIA decoder. When the analytics has been finalized in the pipeline, another plugin allows the bounding boxes delivered by Deepstream to be converted to a format that can be understood by XProtect. In addition to this, the developer can tap into the huge ecosystem of GStreamer plugins or even develop their own plugin if needed for a certain task. This architecture can look like when using Milestone's plugin in a Deepstream pipeline for video analytics. The connection to XProtect is done via the Milestone plugin. The video stream is then processed as usual with decoding, pre-processing, etc. At the end of the pipeline, the second Milestone plugin is used to make it possible to send the video stream plus the metadata resulting from the analytics back to the XProtect system. Deepstream can Docker containers. For discrete GPUs, we are providing both development and deployment containers, and those containers come with all the lower level dependencies to build your applications inside the container. Docker containers are also available for the Jetson family, but only deployment containers in order to minimize the size. You will need to build the applications natively on the Jetson target and create containers by adding binaries to your Docker images, or you can generate Jetson containers from your workstation. Shown here are applications that are packaged as part of the Deepstream SDK. It helps you getting started developing your first applications on Deepstreams. All the source code is also included in this package, so you can examine that. The first app walks you through building a basic Deepstream pipeline from sourcing video from a file to decoding, batching, inferencing, and then showing the results with bounding boxes on the screen. The next applications expands on this, showing how to add multiple networks in a single pipeline and how to process multiple streams and display them on screen in a 2D tile array. The last example adds IoT services through the Message Broker plugin. It shows how to connect to Azure IoT Cloud or send messages to a server using Kafka Message Broker. We also provide a Deepstream app in the package. This app is slightly more complex than the other apps we just saw, but offers full configurability through a config file, which allows you to set all the parameters through this file. For input, you can specify any number of input sources, any type of input source, such as file, RTSP, or direct from a camera, as well as the resolution of the input. For inference, you can control the batch size, network type, network resolution, detection interval, GPU ID, and much more. In addition, you can specify options for a secondary network and tracker. For viewing, you can control how you want to tile your output in a 2D array, which is useful when you are working with multiple input. You can also control the colors and features of on-screen displays, such as the color of the bounding boxes and text. Finally, for output, there are options available to view the stream on the screen with metadata or store it in a file or stream it out over RTSP. This is an app to quickly prototype or demo your pipeline and see how it works in your system. And again, as with the other test apps, all the source code is available in the source directory for you to look at. A lot of resources getting starting, evaluating our pre-trained models, Transfer Learning Toolkit, and the Deepstream SDK. You can see a number of links here to blogs and developer forums, and this is a very good starting point. And the presentation. Thank you very much for attending this session, and I'm now ready to take any questions that you might have. You can also contact me afterwards on the email address listed on this slide.